Hi, my name is Valerio, and I'm here to show you our container mobile refrigerators. These units are designed to keep the perishable products at the right temperature during transport, in order to maintain the cold chain. But to do so, these refrigerators must be connected to the right electric source. So, that's why I'm here today, to show you the different ways in which you can power supply our refrigerators. Take for example the FO720 model. As you may know, you can have this in two different versions, the standard and the autonomous one. The standard version must be connected to the 12 volts battery of the vehicle on which it's mounted. In order to do so, in the scope of delivery, you will find an appropriate power cable that must be connected on one side to the unit and on the other side on the positive and the negative terminals of the vehicle's battery. You do not have to worry to drain your battery, since while you are driving, it's recharged by the vehicle's alternator. By now, you are probably wondering, what happens when I stop the vehicle? The container, of course, will continue to work, since it's connected to the vehicle battery, not to its engine. But also in this case, if it's a short stop, you don't have to worry about draining the battery, since the container perceives the input voltage coming from it. And when this falls below the safety threshold set by us, the refrigerator's compressor is automatically deactivated. This allows you to always have the voltage that you need to start your vehicle's engine. So, as you understand, your vehicle battery can power supply your container both while you are driving and during a short stop, such as, for example, your lunch break. But what happens during a long stop? How can you power supply it, for example, overnight when the vehicles are parked? You have to know that you can power supply the container also with the AC, thanks to this optional AC-DC power supply that you can find here in its appropriate place. You just have to connect its plug into an AC socket, and that's it. This equipment is very important because it allows you to pre-cool the container before leaving, making sure that you respect the right temperature for the products to be transported since the very first minutes of the trip. And moreover, it allows you to minimize the effort of the vehicle's battery, which will only have to maintain the set temperature. Now, let's move to the autonomous models. The technical features are the same as the standard one. As you can see, the outer part is identical and it is also equipped with the same refrigeration unit. So, that means that its performance are absolutely the same as the standard model. Well then, what is the difference? Quite simply, it's just the way in which the two versions are powered. For example, the standard model has to be connected to the vehicle battery through its own power cable. This model instead, as you can see, has its own internal DC battery, which guarantees you an autonomy of at least 8 hours, even in the most demanding condition of use. So, if you choose an autonomous model, you don't have to connect the power cable to the vehicle battery, which is an ideal solution if you have an electric vehicle in which you cannot use its own batteries to power supply the refrigerator. Now, let's see how to properly use container AWO. If you have to transport goods at controlled temperature, for example, fresh foodstuff at +4 degrees, you need to pre-cool the refrigerator during the night. Proceeding with the pre-cooling of the unit while being connected to the AC is very important, because doing so, you do not exploit the battery of the container, maintaining its full state of charge that you will need for the trip. If you do not do so, this will decrease the operational autonomy of your container. First of all, move the main switch to on. Insert the battery charger's plug into an AC socket, insert the power plug into the battery charger and set the switch to 1. Now, Let's move to the display. To switch on, move to 1 and wait a few seconds until the internal temperature appears on the display. If you want to change the temperature, use the up arrow to increase or the down arrow to decrease. When you see the temperature you want to reach, +4 in the example we made before, press the set button and wait for the container to reach the temperature. During the night, the container will have reached the desired temperature and will be ready for the trip. Of course, before leaving, you have to disconnect the battery charger. First of all, turn its switch to off, and then disconnect the battery charger's plug from the AC. Then remove the battery charger power cable. Now you are free to leave with your van and start transporting your goods in controlled temperature with the absolute safety guaranteed by the container for at least 8 hours of use. When you finish your delivery and you go back to your company, you have, of course, to recharge the battery of the container AUO. Pay attention, we recommend to recharge when the LED light approaches the middle of the indicator. And anyway, we strongly recommend to recharge the battery after every trip. Failure to do so will seriously jeopardize the functionality of the battery. Now that I have explained the importance of the recharging phase, I'll explain how to do it. When you have to recharge the battery, move the main switch to on. Then insert the charger plug into an AC socket, insert the power plug into the battery charger, and set the switch to 1. When the refrigerator is running, the battery voltage indicator appears above the main switch. When the green LED on the battery charger stops flashing and remains steady, the charging cycle is completed. At the end of the charging cycle, move the battery charger switch to 0, unplug the power cord, and turn the main switch to off.